Welcome back, everybody. This week, we are stepping away from mobile GPUs and going back to an old faithful, an old standby. This is a Galax CMP 50HX. This card essentially is a, well, it's a mining-specific card released by nVidia in 2021. And it uses a defective RTX 2080 Ti die with a memory subsystem that's somewhere between a 2080 Ti and a 2080 Super. So anyone that calls this a 2080 Ti is wrong. But nevertheless, although it does have some limitations and the bins are all over the place, these cards recently got even better. And that's basically because of the new Dynex performance on SRB Miner 2.3.7, running out of places to stack cards. So you can see right here, this is actually a rig of blower CMP 50HXs that I have at Terra Hosting that I bought off of Vistang. But this has a pretty standard canned overclock on it. I did bump it up a little bit just to the more powerful OCs so you guys could see what these cards can really do. But you can see, since it's in an Octominer, here's our actual wall power, showing 739.3 watts, including fan and overhead for the Octominer. These are blower CMP50s, so they actually tend to over-report on power just a little bit. But you can see what I was saying about the bins. We have Samsung and Micron memory cards here, but they're doing essentially 5 kilohash at around 90 watts, which is really, really quite good. So anyway, let's go over to our GPU sheet. Let's find the 50HX, which is over here. And although I've done videos on this card before, it's been a long time, and I went and looked at it, and I only tested like 3 algorithms. Because at the time, all I really cared about was Flux and Caspa. Nowadays, the landscape is completely different. Caspa may as well not even be GPU mineable because of the network difficulty with the Ice River and Bitmain ASICs. And Flux is kind of missing a lot of deadlines, so although I still really like the project, I have shifted off of it. You will see that I only redid one of the settings with SRB 2.3.7, so the 2.3.6 results bookending it are not accurate anymore. The overclocks will still work, with the exception of maybe this lower one, the 1210 core clock. You may have to drop the offset down a little bit. For the most part, the overclocks still work between 2.3.6 and 2.3.7, but you can see there is a massive hash rate difference, and because of that, you can't push the offset quite as hard because the core is using a little bit more power. So anyway, I want you to focus on this overclock, which is what we're running today, which is 1450 core, 250 core offset, 5000 memory. The card is doing 5 kilohash at 81 watts. You will notice that the power that you just saw in HiveOS there was reading a little higher on average, but again, those are blowers. And what I did essentially was take the known overhead of that system in the fans and remove it from the wall power divided by 8. So it's a decent average, but it's not perfect. I do not have a PMD. I cannot test it there. At some point, if you guys want, I will throw this back on the test bench with a PMD and we can verify, you know, a run-of-the-mill CMP50 twin fan, exactly what it will do. But anyway, I reran a bunch of other algorithms. Conflux, Kyla, ETC, Pigeon, ERGO, Radiant, Ironfish, Alephium, KawPow, NexaPow, and Flux. So this card, still, I still really, really like these. If you can pick them up for around $100, it's a no-brainer in my opinion. Even if you have like a regular power rate, if you have cheap power, these are fantastic. So Flux, we're hitting almost 0.5 efficiency, which is quite good. 30 series is still doing 0.6 in a lot of cases, but for a 20 series GPU, pretty happy with these. Nexa, they're really quite good at. KawPow, it's okay. 0.178 is okay. I would consider 0.2 kind of my base threshold for anything I would actually put on KawPow, especially when you can get a card like the BC160, which will do in excess of 0.2 for less money. Ironfish and Alephium, it's pretty good. Let me pull up the actual efficiency sheet. So iron, 150. It's quite good, so it's not perfect. Alephium 17 is quite good. Oh, sorry about that. The power supply fan in my test bench here is having a lot of issues these days. So Alephium, we're at 12, 17 is considered good, so it's okay. Radiant, 7, what do we got? RxD, 10 is considered good. So these are okay, 8.37. Again, these aren't 30 series cards, but you're not paying 30 series money for them either. ERGO, 0.9, not actually that great. The memory subsystem on the touring cards, even ones with wider buses like this, which is a 320-bit card, not great. The GDDR6 just doesn't seem to be that quick, but these are really good cards for compute. So things like Dynex, you'll see, 62 hash to watt is really good. These are very, very close to on par with like a 3070 in efficiency. Those do get up to 70 hash to watt, but 62, especially considering the hash rate, quite happy with that. ETHhash, actually, I was pretty impressed with these. This is about 2080 Ti hash rate, and the memory bus is like 32 bits narrower on this card, so not bad. These are micron by and large, so 1800 offset is pretty much all the memory will take. Conflux, I really don't mind it enough to know if that's good or bad efficiency, but it looks like we got up to 0.322. I will say Gminer was awful, so I reran it with an older T-Rex, and that was a lot better. So the top results here, I don't think I would even lend credence to those. But yeah, there are my results on the CMP50HX. I know a lot of you have requested I rerun it, so we did, and there are the results. I'm still a huge fan of this card, by and large. Long term, I'm sure I'll keep a couple around, but SRB, man, 2.3.7, that's kind of a hidden gem. Touring GPUs especially picked up a ton of efficiency and hash rate, so maybe worth looking at depending on your power situation. But again, I had so many people request that we rerun a 50HX, and there you go. I'll catch you next week, probably.